In this video, I will show you how to recognize neurons and glial cells in the spinal cord. This is a cross-section of a spinal cord. We can recognize gray matter in the center and white matter in the periphery. Gray matter in the center has typical butterfly pattern. It really looks like butterfly wings or a letter H. But what's more important is that we can find big neurons there. Neurons can be found in gray matter only. They are multipolar, which means that they have many processes. Spherical, ovoid light active nucleus with nucleolus is typical, because neurons are very active cells in terms of production. Cytoplasm contains rough endoplasmic reticulum and free polyribosomes, and they are organized in Nissl bodies, these basophilic dots, or so-called Nissl substance. That's why the whole cytoplasm of the neuron is described as basophilic. We can also differentiate processes of neurons such as dendrites, which transmit signal towards the body, and one axon that transmits signal to another neuron or to an end organ and goes to the white matter. Axon doesn't branch, doesn't contain Nissl substance, that's why it's eosinophilic, and is heading to the white matter. Dendrites, on the other hand, branch a lot. Sometimes we can see the branches, sometimes we can't because they are too thin, but they contain the Nissl substance. Glial cells are smaller cells located in both gray and white matter. They have several functions and they look different. We can only see their nuclei in hematoxylin eosin staining. Let's start with astrocytes. We distinguish protoplasmic and fibrous astrocytes. These are the nuclei of protoplasmic astrocytes in gray matter. Their nuclei are light, oval, and the biggest of all glial cells. Astrocytes contain bundles of intermediate filaments made up of glial fibrillary acid protein, which serve as a unique marker for these glial cells in pathology. Their function is structural and metabolic support of neurons, especially at synapses. Oligodendrocytes have smaller, spherical nuclei. These cells wrap their processes repeatedly around a portion of a nearby axon in the central nervous system and create a myelin sheath. Myelin sheath is important for the conduction of a nerve impulse in the axon. We can see myelin sheaths in white matter here. These are the axons with myelin sheath around. Axons should be in the center, but they moved a little bit because of the preparation of the slide. There are oligodendrocytes in white matter, as well as fibrous astrocytes, which are those big lads over here. We can't really tell them apart based exclusively on appearance of the nucleus, which one is fibrous and which one protoplasmic. We just know that white matter contains fibrous astrocytes with longer processes. But let's go back to the gray matter. Another type of glial cells are microglial cells. Microglia are small cells with actively mobile processes, evenly distributed throughout gray and white matter. Microglia are the immune system of the CNS. They differentiate from monocytes just like macrophages in proper connective tissue. They remove dead parts of cells, produce immunoregulatory substances, provide protection against harmful substances and bacteria. They have elongated nuclei and they are very similar to endothelial cells, which line capillaries in the nervous system, so don't confuse these two. Last type of glial cells that can be found in the central nervous system are ependymal cells. These guys line the ventricular system. We can find them in the region of the central canal in the spinal cord. They kind of look like epithelial cells. They are columnar or cuboidal, but they lack a basal lamina. We say that they are lined in epithelioid fashion. In simple terms, they resemble epithelial tissue. They have apical specializations like cilia, which facilitate the movement of cerebrospinal fluid, and long microvilli, which help in absorption. They are involved in formation of the fluid as well. Well, there you have it. Just a brief recap. White matter is composed of myelinated axons, and we can find glial cells such as fibrous astrocytes, oligodendrocytes, and microglia there. Gray matter contains neurons and glial cells such as protoplasmic astrocytes, oligodendrocytes, microglia, and ependymal cells. We differentiate glial cells based on their nuclei, but they have a lot of processes. These processes, together with dendrites and axons, create a meshwork in gray matter called neuropil.